Good morning. We are on Bessy Cove, which is near Plein Cove in Cornwall. A little cute cove that I'm loving the water. I don't know if you can see it. It's a turquoisey water down there. And the little hut over there. So I'm hoping to capture the water and the hut and the edge of the headland. So that's my plan. So yeah, it's a January morning. It was cold, but it's feeling a lot warmer and brighter. So I'm ready to get started. I've got a 12 by 16 board at the moment, which is a 30 by 40 in centimetres. And I'm hoping I'm going to be able to, with the composition, get that little hut in and the edge of the headland down here, plus the water down there. So I'm kind of asking for quite a lot. I don't know whether I'm going to have the headland coming off the board. I don't know yet. I have to try the scale first with it. So if we've got that there. So I'm just kind of mapping out at the moment. I don't want to put lots of drawing in first until I know where things are going to go, because I might change the board. So it's quite difficult when you've got a big subject like this to get everything in you want. So one thing I can do is like get some of it in, and then at home do a bigger painting with all of it in. So that's what I've got to kind of say to myself. Don't worry if you can't get it all in. But it is annoying. So how is that looking? That's not right. That needs to go maybe here. I love that light behind the headland. Can you see that kind of really light blue sea? And then the headland in front of it is just really yummy. So I hope that I can get some of that in. That's the plan. I've decided to make it a little bit smaller in scale, because at the moment it's kind of almost bulging off my board. It's too big. So I think it's one of the things I tend to do. You know, I want to get everything in. Right, let's try again. I've used my viewfinder and I've just changed the scale on it because it's a bit too deep, this one, for the scale of the board. So I'm just moving it down a bit and having a look for what I can fit in and where it is. Okay. So that's what it looks like. I don't know if you can see through there. Thank you. I'm going to try again. Trying to make it a bit smaller if I can manage. And this time I'm going to have the headland coming off the edge of the thing, finishing around there. There's more and more rocks and less water. So the tide's going out, which is a boo, because I love that water in there. I have to come back when it's higher tide.
It's been full moon lately, hasn't it? So.
Yeah, the full moon's been here, so it makes it bigger tides. That's what happens. Just kind of mapping out again and seeing if it's the right feel. I do a lot by feel, the composition. You know, if it feels right, then it is right. I quite like it that the sun is on the side of the subject, so you get quite a lot of nice shadow shapes, which is good. Coming, I think that's better. So this little hut thing is so important. It really helps the composition, you know, a nice focal point. Yeah, that's better. Phew, gosh, not easy. So if I can get these rocks in now, because they're going to keep changing because the tide's going out, at least then I've got the shape right and this water in the bottom of my painting. Good. It's always a bit of a relief to get the composition right when you're starting, because it can make or break the painting, and if it's not right, then it's, you can't kind of carry on really. Okay, I think that's probably enough drawing. Oh, maybe get the horizon in just to check the size of that. That's around about there, which is a lot better. It was a bit high on that first attempt. Yeah. Let's make it go down a little bit more so we get more in there. Okay. I think we might start. So I don't always mix my colours before I start painting. The upside of doing that is that when you're kind of in the flow of the painting, you don't have to stop to mix, and you can get more on your brush. So it encourages you to paint more thickly. So this one, I want a dark, you know, it's almost like a black, but because I've mixed two complementaries, which is blue and, well, ultramarine and burnt sienna, it makes a really good neutral. And then you can push it either to the blue side or the brown side, warm or cool. And that's a good starting point. So I'm going to use it for those dark darks down there. You can see the rocks. The dark shadows, and I've just made a browner version as well. So now I'm gonna mix some blues, I think. The blues are so pretty, love them. We've got a lot of reflection from the sky, especially that bit behind the headland. I'm going to go with cobalt blue to start with, and a little bit of lemon and cad yellow. So generally most of my mixes have the three primaries in. So that's the blue and the yellow, and then I'm going to use just a little bit of Scarlet Lake. Oh, that was too much. You can see that was too much. So I need to go back and change that. Take some of that out. Get a nice chunk there. And go back to the yellow. They're so powerful, these yellows. You have to be careful. See how much that's tinted it. So I use the complementaries, the three complementaries, because well, every colour out there has them in, just different proportions, and it makes it less bright as well, less saturated in colour. So I'm going to get that more sky colour. So that was kind of the watercolour. I'm now going to do the sky colour. So that's cerulean with some titanium white, and lemon yellow. And it is really quite light as well, so making sure I've got the tonal values as well. So that can kind of be my mid, and now I need an even lighter one as well. It's a bit more white, too much, more yellow. So that will help with the sky. I always wipe in between to make sure I'm not muddying the colours. I'm going to do some greens now. So the blue that you start really affects the green. I do like cerulean blue as a base because it's quite light in tone. So it means you can control the tonal values more. And because it's a cool blue, I'm going to contrast that with a warm yellow. So that's cadmium yellow. It comes out a really nice colour, and again I'm going to put some red in it, so there's my three primaries. But make sure I don't put too much in. So that's a good start. I'm going to do another one, which is a bit darker. So less yellow, more red and blue. So you can see the difference, the same colours. Darker version. You can see here that there is sand on my board. I think we might start. We've probably got enough on there. I'm going to take that away, don't need that. So I'm going to tackle the rocks first because I want them as they are at the moment. I always do the darks really thin, especially dark darks. And I need to make sure that they are dark, but sometimes they can be too dark. So I'm just doing a little test there. So that's a shadowy area. I kind of want to put the main area in first, so I'm going to just use a tiny amount of white. Because if the whole area is too dark to start with, then I can't put the dark shadows in of the rocks. So sometimes it takes a bit of adjusting, yeah, to-ing and fro-ing. And see what's right. Because this first marks really make a difference. Because you kind of assume that, you know, when you look down on those rocks there behind, underneath the little cabin, that they are just dark. All of them are dark, and they're not. When you squint your eyes, they're actually not that dark. Just make sure that I'm going to do it right, because I don't want to do it again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start where the darker ones are, which is up here, and work down. Make sure I've got enough. A lot of to-ing and fro-ing, fussing, making sure it's right. I know. Forgotten to use one of my favourite browns, which is the raw umber. That's quite useful. Just putting a little bit of that colour in. Let's try that again. Yes, that's better. It has a kind of a yellowy colour in it. I still think it's a little bit dark. Ugh. Again, doesn't look any bloody different. Oops, excuse me. quite cool with those people on that headland, to remember that. So as I go, I'm changing the colours a little bit, make sure that there is some variation. It's so still. We're pretty blessed to be out here. So there's my three primaries again. I just did the same thing. So I can't get all those rocks in. I have to decide the ones that I actually want to show and put in. And you do that kind of on the hoof. Why? On the hoof?
Go on.
A good word. Maybe a little bit warmer, and the light is on top of them, so I have to make sure they're not too dark. Still quite dark, but if you put too much white in there, it gets chalky, so there's a fine balance. So lots of back and forth. Golly, this is not my usual subject, and so I have to kind of feel my way through it. You are witnessing my feeling. I'm making sure that I've got lots of energy in my brushwork as well, so it makes it interesting. I can add some light over the top of these. These rocks. Okay, I'm going to just make that a little bit longer. I want the sea to come in a bit more. It's a better shape. I'm doing these really quite thin. Then I can work over the top of them. All right, it's coming. Need to make sure I get the shadow shapes in as well fairly soon, because they're going to change a lot. Let me just get this in. I've done that one a little bit darker to give it a bit more impact, being closer. Okay, let's So a bit more up here. And I got that. So there's a kind of a shadow in the rocks there. At the base here. Made it a bit cooler. Might be a bit dark. I'm just going to look for other shadows as well so it can link it together. So. Just warming it up a bit with some red and yellow. Cleaning it off. I want to get some darker darks in there, darker shadows. So it's got quite a good blue tinge in there. So you can see that because I've done it quite light and it's a light dark, but also a thin dark, so I can add definition and shapes and the shadows. I'm putting those in now because they're going to change. Subtle variations. I've probably done enough to start on the next bit. So my next bit's probably, I tend to try and start the bit that I've done already. I put the thing next to it so then I can compare whether it's right or not. So that's the grassy, banky bit. When I squint my eyes, it's really light. So I have to make sure that I have to do it light enough. So that colour that I mixed already was not light enough. I've put more yellow in and some white. Yes.
Do you mind just coming by?
Not at all.
Oh, I hate it. Somebody watching.
That's fine. We're filming. Just started off. Yeah.
Perfect morning.
I know. I've got way too many clothes on.
It's. Oh, join the clan.
Yeah.
Join the clan. But whatever.
Yes, we're not complaining.
No.
Gorgeous. You're going for a walk.
Well, yeah, I think it might be quite a long one. She's kept it a bit quiet, really.
We're hoping we're on the right path. We're up there, which is slightly worrying.
Hello.
Is that the proper path? Is that...
I think you're on the proper path.
Okay, good. Good to know. Thanks. Enjoy.
Have a good day. Yeah. Bye. So although that headland grass is light compared to the rocks, it's dark compared to the sea behind it especially. So everything is relative. So I'm going to put a bit of this in and then see how it looks with the water behind. Get that water in. Make sure it's light enough, because it's really light. Not light enough. It's better. That's a little bit bright, so I'm going to put a bit of red in there. Should have had a bigger brush. Sometimes when you know, do a new subject, you can be quite tentative. So I have to make myself go against that. So a bigger brush does help. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, better. Okay. So we've got a darker line on the horizon that I really should put in. I guess I could come back with that brush. I'm going to graduate the sea down. I think it needs more warmth in there. Yeah, there's a wind line out there that is right on the horizon, and it looks quite amazing. Shows how still it is today. Here. sometimes I think the water is, it's kind of a greeny blue, and then another time I think, no, it's purpley. So I'm guessing it's both. Make sure it's not too bright either. Is it? So my trusty husband and cameraman is saying that the wind is building a little, so there's going to be some lines of... Yeah, it's going to darken over the headland, so okay, let's get that in. Feels as though it's quite purpley in that bit there. We also want that lovely turquoisey colour as well. I'm not sure I'm going to get that. I don't know if I can just get some of that turquoise colour in there and mix the two, make it work. So let's see. So I'm not talking so you can make it go faster on this bit.
Okay. Well, you're going to time lapse it.
Yeah, well, you can just speed it up.
All right. Yeah.
So I'm not talking so you can. So I've emphasised this a little bit, this area, because it's a bit I like. And it was there when I started, it's not quite there now, because the tide's gone out. So now I have to kind of marry the two together. Very calm spot here, it's lovely. Get the sky in now. I always try and do the sky and the water at the same time because they reflect the same colours or similar colours, and then I know what I've done. So it's really quite yellow, that sky on the horizon. I'd like to get that bit just done as well. So it needs more yellow in there. I find the Naples yellow light is really useful in the sky.
Sorry to disturb. Is that right?
What, behind the gate?
No, I've just come through here and popped up over the gate, but I don't know if I can carry on this path if this is the public one or not.
It is public.
Oh right, okay, yeah, brilliant. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. I feel I need to make the rocks sit in the water better. At the moment it looks like they're floating away from the water. So clear an area. I'm using some cobalt blue. Lemon yellow and scarlet. Kind of make a dark colour, but that's possibly too dark. Someone's just gone in the water and it just looks so inviting down there because it's really still and pretty. Looks yummy.
Different.
Yes, it's obviously it looks pretty, but it's rather chilly, as we know. it's making it a little bit warmer. I think it's a bit too blue. Surprising amount of red reflected down, so I need to make those rocks darker because they are now too light. To give them an edge. Just putting some shadows in to give some definition to the rocks and some shape. Some of the rocks out here have now disappeared, but I can add some license. So I need to make that rock area a little bit lighter. So in this area here, I've done it very thin to make it look lighter, but now it needs a bit of kind of fattening up with the paint because it's just still a bit thin. Kind of doesn't have enough substance to it. I've still got to make it look kind of rocky. How do you do that? I guess adding lots of textures and shadows. It looks a bit better just by putting those bits in, I think. I'm looking for the light areas. These are the bits that really help bring it together when you've got some lights on there as well as the darks. So I'm looking for where the light is hitting it, you know, at the strong areas. And building the shapes up. Some up there too. So now I'm going to go back with my darks and just see whether it's the right tone, that light. Put a few darks in round it. So I've gone quite light with these darks. I'm going to do this bit up here. So when I see an area that I'm, you know, I think needs a bit of adjusting, and I do it, because otherwise I forget. So I don't just leave it, I come back. Too yellow. So we're probably 3/4 of the way through the painting. This is where you kind of need to keep the momentum going. I'm feeling a little bit tired. I might get a cup of tea. So I've got my mobile flask just to keep me going. It's an enjoyable paint. I do, you know, it's very lovely, perfect conditions. So I just got to push on and kind of bring it together. Cup of tea. So I've just mixed some Naples yellow light to make this sky more yellowy. It's quite often yellow in the morning, so I'm just going to see whether that works or not. And I think it's actually a bit warmer. So I'm just going to adjust that a bit and just see. I always do testers. And it's very light in tone as well, tonal value. Let's try again. So I compare the water to the headland to the sky, and I see if those three things are working together. And I think they're okay. So as the sky goes up, it goes a little bit cooler. So I'm going to add some cerulean in there, just a little bit, mixed in with that Naples yellow. Make sure I've got enough white in there as well. It's a good start. That's maybe a little bit steep. I'm going to leave that now and just work on that bit, maybe add a bit more blue. I think I've gone a bit yellow with that horizon. Pardon, I can tell now because I've got the blue in and compare it. Don't like it. All relative. So because I've now sullied that brush, I'm going to go in with another brush. It's a bit small, but it doesn't matter. So it needs to be warm, you know, a bit of yellow in there, but not as over the top as I had it just now. Rest of the sky in. And then go back to the grassy bit. So yeah, I think it's coming on. It's once I get this grass in, I think I'll really be able to tell whether it's working or not, kind of at that stage. Squinting my eyes to see the tonal values. So I can sculpt in with that greens around the rocks to make the shapes. There's a lovely green, really strong green over there, just here. It's really nice. I'm going to have to get that in. So the rest of the greens are quite brown. You know, there's a lot of red in them. So I think I might get that bright in before I change the colour to a redder. So I chose some cadmium yellow, white and red. It needs a bit more yellow. Sometimes you put a colour on and it's a little bit kind of like, woo, that's a bit scary. But you kind of need that sometimes to lift the painting. I'm just going to see if there's any other areas I can do it. Um, So I'm now going to add a bit more red. Now I've done that bit. Not enough. I like to make sure that I'm happy with the colour and not just say it'll do. You know, I want it to be as right as I can make it for my painting. It doesn't have to be exact match, just, you know, as long as it works as a whole. See, I'm changing the colour and slight tone as I go up. It's still not that dark though. Adding a bit of blue in there. Making every brush stroke count, as they say. All right, it's coming. Just going to fill that in. I should do that hut because it was one of my focal things and I want to get that right, and sooner than later. So it's nice because it's really lit well with the sun too, so I have to make the most of that. I'm just going to put a bit of colour behind it. See what we've got brush wise. So I'm using short flats, some of them anyway, and they're the Rosemary Co Ultimate Short Flat. So it's a bristle brush. I'm looking at I'm tackling it by looking at it in three sides. So there's the roof is the mid tone, the front is obviously very light, and then the side is dark, so that's kind of what I'm looking at. So this roof has to make sure that I don't do it too dark, because then the side will be too dark, because that's darker, if you get what I mean. It's quite difficult to make a dark without it being a dark milky. Ugh. Whatever. I think we're going to edit that bit out. Probably making that a bit big, but
that's right. Also, the buildings look heading away from us at the moment.
stick the dark in and then I can tell. I'm going to just put this dark in. Oof, he's a bit blue. Maybe a bit dark, but making him a bit smaller. Shadows in there. So I'm kind of desperate to put some of these shadows in too. Need to be quicker. I'm a bit slow because I'm not familiar and it's not my usual subject, but I'm enjoying it. Hope you are too. I'm not worried too much about getting all the details in, it's just kind of the shapes. I think that will be okay. So I need to fill in the areas. Yes. I could put them in other words. Because I'm not speaking, because I thought you can speed this up. That's why I'm... But yes. Just notice those people on the headland there. I wonder if I can get them in. They're really small. I've got a rigger brush here. I don't use it very much for things like this, but if I make too big a mark, it will look wrong. There's a post there, and then kind of like, they look like ants. They're disappearing fast. Almost like commas. That sort of shape. Well, I'll leave them in for now and see if I keep them there. Big subject. kind of need to fill in the gaps. Get this path in. Just take that down a little bit. Some green on there, which I've those greens right are tricky. Got my cuppa. Feel a bit better. I'm going to ignore that, Mr. B. So I want to just work on these far away rocks. I feel as though they need kind of lightening a little bit on the tops, because they are, the light is hitting them. But they still must be dark. Makes them kind of come alive a little bit better. now I'm doing this, I feel as though I need to get the darks in again in some areas. So you put the lights in and then it feels like they're not the right shape. And now I want to go round. That bit there, and it's the wrong colour. I know that the rocks have changed, but I'm not happy with the shape. I have to come back to that one. Alright. So what was I doing? I got distracted then. Oh yes, I was going to put some more darks in, wasn't I? Make sure I've got that as light as I need to, which is this bit over here. Darks to keep my focus. You know, I don't know how long I've been going now, but yeah. Yes, it is a test of what's the word? Endurance sometimes doing these paintings. You want to kind of finish it, but you're also really tired. Okay. Let's just have another look at that cottage up there to make sure I've done it as best I can at the moment. I'm going to sculpt around the back of it, try and get the shape better. Sitting in the kind of the headland there. I'm going to put him in as well. Probably help if I put the windows in, even just a suggestion of them. Not too dark. Actually, that's When I do that, I realise it's not quite the right shape. The big old gap there I need to fill in. Quite green. Just add some bit of texture to the water. I think it's a bit lacking at the moment. That's too dark. There's a little bit of movement in there. And also it's a little bit thicker too. Thicker paint. It's always a bit tricky because it's obviously changed massively. But I'll give it a go. Also just making sure these rocks work. Hiya.
Hey.
Yeah.
Hi. You could come round a little bit this way. coming.
Mm.
I'm just looking at him and thinking he looks a little bit dark, possibly. I think he needs a bit brightening. I'm adding kind of just textures into the water a little bit. Although there's not much happening, there is some movement in there. So these are my kind of last few kind of areas to finish off. Lifting areas and pushing things back and making sure it all works okay. So I'm just going to put a bit more of the sky reflecting in some places. It helps to have kind of different depth. Color. Just going to go back to that. It's annoying. And just lift him a little bit. A little bit of warm white, Naples yellow, cerulean. And a bit of that mix that I've got there already. It's quite light. Yeah, that's better. I want him to stand out enough. There's a nice chimney there as well. Something down there as well, but I haven't really got that in. I'm going to go back now with getting those windows back in, making sure they're defined enough. But not too strong. And also the chimney, if I can do it. There is a dark shadow underneath the lip in the front that I think would help as well. make it too strong, that line. Right, I think we're nearly there. So I've just noticed the shadows up there in the kind of the next to that field at the top in here. I don't know if you saw that then here. So I thought that it might be a good idea to get these in a bit more to give it a bit more definition. There's some nice posts. I don't know if that's too much detail, but we'll try it just to give an idea of it. And then it's quite purpley, that colour. I don't want it too dark either, because I don't want it to stand out too much, just to give some definition. Hi. Yes.
Up to the right.
Up there. That's public.
Okay, so it's both public, is it?
The right. The path to the right is public, but not the road to the left.
Yeah.
An idea that the shadows are all in this area because it's the sun isn't kind of coming round here, it's gone, and I don't know if that's actually looking right now. Whether I take some of it out, just soften it a bit. Could go on a lot longer doing this painting because there is a lot to it, but it's kind of knowing when to stop. Also, so this horizon, well, not horizon, bank. Needs just a little bit more definition. I've got this thing here, make it a bit bigger. Don't want it too strong, it's a bit strong. So last bits. And then we'll finish. Just putting a little bit of emphasis, but not too much. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm happy with that. Hard to judge when I've been so intense working on it for a couple of hours or so, but I think it's come out as good as I could make it today, and I might tweak it a little bit at home, but hope you've enjoyed this. And this is, what is it, Sheila Bay? No.
Bessy.
Bessy Bay. So cute, what a cute name. Bessy Bay in Cornwall. And if you have liked this video, do subscribe to me and like it. Thank you so much. See you next time.